In the beginning, you do have some initial observation. From this initial observation, you derive a hypothesis, a possible explanation for what you just observed. If the hypothesis explains your observation, the hypothesis must be useful to make a prediction. In our example, the initial observation was the apple falling. The hypothesis would be, well, every solid object falls down. And then a prediction would be, if I take this plate and let it fall, it's going to go straight down towards the floor. It may also break along the way. This is what 3-year-olds do. The experiment means to actually verify the prediction. So you take the plate and let it fall. From the experiment comes the observations. What do you see? Well, the plate actually was attracted towards the ground. And so you can now go and check whether what you just observed in your experiment is as predicted and therefore satisfies the hypothesis. Then we say it supports the hypothesis, and we then can refine the hypothesis. In our case, for instance, we can generalize it towards other objects and to come up with a more general hypothesis. If the observation, however, is not in line with your prediction, then the hypothesis is rejected. And if the hypothesis is rejected, you need to come up with a new hypothesis. And this cycle, going along from hypothesis through prediction, through experiment, through observation, and gradually refining the hypothesis or coming up with alternatives, this is something you repeat again and again until your hypothesis becomes consistent with all observations and has so much predictive power that it becomes what one calls a theory. And a theory, you repeat the process of refining the hypothesis through prediction, experiment, observation, or creating new hypotheses, again, going through this circle again and again and again until your hypothesis becomes a theory. That is, a predictive and comprehensive description of some aspect of reality.